And in sports news, Gboyega Okegbenro gives an insight to a different side of MKO Abiola that many were unaware of. The sports and public communications consultant gives an insight into the remarkable sports enthusiast who became a pillar of sports in Africa.
It is indeed a pleasure to join this conversation on the legendary and irreplaceable first ever pillar of sport in Africa, late special Moshood Kashimao Abiola. Like a lot of the previous contributors that made clear, we can take an entire day and a full length program to talk about MKO, but basically, at the risk of repeating what everyone had said, it is extremely important for us to keep emphasizing that Nigerian sports leaders, from the highest level of government to the lowest, must begin to take a conscious and different look at improving sports generally. M.K.O. Abiola was different. He was unique in a lot of senses because he operated with sheer passion. He was true and true altruistic about his involvement and commitment to sport. And that reflected in a lot of the results we got under his watch, starting from the teams he sponsored, from various competitions that he invested in, and much more in particular with the results that his football club Abiola has achieved in the few years that he campaigned on the national scene. Much more importantly, you also want to look at Abiola's involvement, not just with competitive sports organizing or funding, but even the adjunct sectors that work with sports. He also supported and encouraged a lot of us in the media, up to even supporters club for various teams. And Abiola was not focused on just one sport. I remember sometime around 1983-84, when the late Dr. Ashekun became president of National Swimming, Abiola drove to the stadium in company with about 18 of his children in one brand new bus, took them around the swimming pool, went and prostrated for Dr. Ashekun and gave a commitment. And for about 6 years, Abiola was sponsoring under 14, under 16 National Swimming Championships. He didn't stop at that. He went into track and field, also in the early 80s, and sponsored the National Collegiate Track and Field. And that was where those days we discovered the likes of Shadi Ashumi, Falila Togunkoya, Marion Yeli, all of those junior girls, Victor Magbemi, a lot of those youngsters came through from that 8-grade competition. Abiola sponsored that for about 6, 7, 8 years. And these were full sponsors, all from his pocket. He would go out of his way to go to the grassroots and invest and support competitions, support sports federations, without expecting anything in return. And last but not the least, because it's also very important, on the heels of Nigeria's preparation for 1988 Seoul Olympics, we had this crisis of funds and all of that, and the Federal Minister of Sports and the Sports Commission then approached Abiola. Abiola took his own private jet and chartered another private jet. He was head of the national fundraising team, and without one cover from the government, toured 36 states of the federation. He led a company of about 18 administrators. He was meeting governors. He was meeting corporate organizations. And he raised millions of money that Nigeria deployed to send the contingent to the 19th Olympics. One can go on and on. So these are not things you want to dismiss with a wave of the hand. Like I said, there is no time, and we can keep talking about M.K.O. Abiola. We will just continue to pray that God Almighty keeps his memories fresh, continue to grant him eternal rest, and give us more Abiolas in the Nigerian sports scene.
Interesting insights there.